Let us study about drift velocity of free electrons. We have discussed that in the situation of a conductor, when a battery is connected across it and the circuit is closed, you can just have a look on the situation I am drawing here. There is a battery which is connected across a cylindrical conductor via switch. As soon as the battery is closed, this positive terminal of the battery and negative terminal of the battery will apply a potential difference across the terminals. Say on the negative side we consider zero potential, then on the positive side potential will be V volt higher than the negative terminal. So there exists a potential difference, and from high potential to low potential an electric field E is established in the conductor, due to which the free electrons in the conductor will experience a force in leftward direction. Here if the switch was open, in that situation we can see that every free electron would be in random motion. They'll behave just like gas molecules in a container and would be in Brownian motion like this. But as soon as the switch is closed, an electric field is established and every electron will experience a force EE in the direction opposite to the electric field, due to which these electrons have a tendency to move toward left, and all these electrons will start moving toward left. And certainly due to their random motion, they cannot move in a straight line. They'll move in a random zigzag path toward left, because continuously during motion these are also colliding with the neighboring electrons. So we can say overall drift of electrons will exist in leftward direction, but these will not move straight. So in this situation we can say due to continuous collisions with the neighboring electrons, each electron we can say will experience a force for their drift due to the electric field EE, and will also experience a force which is the opposing force due to continuous collision on electrons opposite to the direction of their motion. The speed of electron is V. Due to continuous collisions, the wet friction the electron will experience can be written as kV, which is directly proportional to the speed. So in this situation, if we find out the acceleration of electrons, acceleration of free electrons can be written as EE minus kV by m. And here you can say due to acceleration the speed of electrons will increase, and as electron speed increases, this opposing force increases because the rate of collision increases with the speed of electrons. So this kV is increasing, that will reduce the acceleration, and at some maximum speed this acceleration becomes 0. We can say this will be equals to 0 when the speed becomes EE by k. Here k is just a proportionality constant which depends on lattice parameter of the material in which the electrons are flowing. So here we can see this is the speed which electrons will attain when acceleration becomes 0. That means these electrons will further move with this constant speed. And here you can see the speed is directly proportional to the applied electric field. This can be written as mu E, where mu is another constant, which is the ratio of electron charge and constant K, which we have used in finding the opposing force on electron due to collisions. Now this is the speed we write as Vd, or this is called drift speed of electrons in current carrying conductor. So this is the speed with which electrons will continuously flow on an average, and it will remain constant, and it will constitute the constant current in the circuit. That's why we can say on applying the battery potential difference, when an electric field is set up, electrons, free electrons in the conductor will not continuously accelerate. These will not continuously accelerate. These will accelerate for a short while and finally attain a drift speed when the electric force and the force due to continuous collision on electrons with their neighbors get balanced. So that is the speed with which in a current carrying conductor free electrons travel. This is proportional to the electric field, and here the proportionality constant mu we term as mobility of free electrons in the metal. It depends on the lattice parameters of the metal, as well as it depends on the temperature. If we increase the temperature, certainly rate of collision increases due to more randomness and mobility will decrease. That also we'll discuss.